I found it on Rhema Radio.
I'm Ray Poon, and on this show, we speak to Christian business owners on what it takes to do business God's way. Today, we have CC Ngei from Feruni. Now, established in 2001, Feruni Ceramiche is one of the leading brands in the upmarket ceramic and porcelain tiles. Feruni provides high-quality tiles from various ISO 19001 accredited plants located in both Malaysia, China, Italy, and Spain. So welcome, CC. How are you today?
Yeah, I'm good.
Thanks for you. I'm good. Thanks for accepting our offer to share a little bit about how God has touched your life and your business as well. Tell us a little bit, if you can, how you actually came into this business.
Okay, actually, I'm in this business since I was very young. After Form 3, I can't pass my exam, so I have no choice going to help my father because my father also in the same business. So I helping my father is about 11 years.
Okay.
Then actually I start the trading business after that with my partner about another 9 years. Then we split. So only actually in 2010, then actually we start to actually tell ourselves that we want to do something different. Mm-hmm. This is how Feruni come about.
Right. And I know you have a very interesting story as well because it was probably not an easy journey for you, being the fact that you have been in this business for a long time. And obviously, as you were in the business, you were not a believer yet. And halfway through that process of that split and change and transforming into a new, let's call it a new entity in 2010, that was when you actually became a believer.
Yes.
And obviously, you had an option to choose God's way, continue walking God's way, and probably had to make a lot of changes. Or keep things as they were before because you have been already used to the tradition of how things were run. Tell me a little bit about how that was, what challenges and what was in your mind and what went down.
Okay, actually, as our industry, I think the big thing that changed what God changed me is actually the perspective of how we should run the company and how actually we should behave ourselves. I think this is a big paradigm shift. Compared in the past and now. I think one of the things that very obviously is actually in the Malaysia business environment, a lot of time when we actually do business, especially in our industry, that you need to give under-table money.
Yes.
Without giving all these things, you can't really actually run your business.
Right.
So I think this is actually a struggle when actually I become a Christian. Mm-hmm. So because the Bible always tells us that this is not something we are supposed to do.
Right.
So... But this is actually always in my mind that I tell myself, since this is actually the word of God, I might find a way to how we can actually overcome this thing.
Sure.
So I'm very glad that the past few years, actually, we can actually stop to paying any single cent of commission that we're still able to survive. The importantly that we still grow our business.
This
is something that I feel very amazing, that how God blesses in a different way.
So by being obedient to God's calling and being different, let's call it God's differentiation, that indirectly brought some differentiation to your business as well in the eyes of your customers, and in that sense actually grew your business.
Yeah. I think because of this thing, because we know that we are not going to have any way to actually pay money to get our business done.
Yep.
So I was actually thinking, and the whole shifting is really very focused how to we can actually make ourselves different in terms of product, in terms of service, in terms of everything that we do. I think this is actually how God give us the wisdom to actually change our perspective and change the way that we run our business.
Right. Do you think that's reflected in your unique DCC approach, which you are trademarked, which is discover, collection, and create? Do you think that has inspired that concept itself because of the way you want to run God's ways?
Yeah, definitely. I think this is only one of the ways. You actually have much more than that. Mm-hmm. Actually, when you go to our showroom, you can see a very distinguished, different compare the way that we run our business and compare with others. I think this is something that because our always thinking that how we can actually benefit the customer and solving the customer problem.
Right.
And this is how the way that we run our business.
Right. Thank you for sharing that. And interestingly enough, I also noticed that your belief and you know, I guess God's calling in the way that you should run your business also translates into the core values of your company. Right. And I noticed you have 10 core values there. And share a little bit about how that was God inspired.
Yeah, because actually, Because actually, frankly speaking, in the past, actually, I have always a challenge how to actually understand Bible. Every time that I want to read Bible, I will fall asleep. That's always my struggle. So, but one day, there's one pastor actually inspired me. That actually, he told me that actually have one, we call it leadership Bible. Yeah. It's actually by John Maxwell. So there's actually, I got very excited because when I actually read all the so-called principle from the Bible, it actually translated to the leadership. Yeah. So from there, I actually got a lot of inspiration. So that's one day I tell myself how actually we can live all this value, because whatever the Bible say that actually you can, a lot of things we can actually put it in our company.
That's
this
right.
is actually how we started
right.
putting all the right value that make sure that people behave.
Yeah.
Because we always believe that with the right value, then we can actually form a very good behavior. Then actually, you mentioned we can form a
right.
very great
right.
culture.
So now we're breathing God's word alive in your business as well.
Yes, precisely.
And I noticed out of the 10 core values, one of the interesting things was to deliver happiness. What does that mean? What does that mean?
Because it's our idea is very simple, that we have a four key purpose to make people happy.
Right.
So one of the things is actually cultivate talent. Because right. when I read the Bible, that's actually how God bring the 12 disciples to spread the word of God.
Developing them.
Excellent. Because you see, I always believe that God have created people with a special talent. Just like the 12 disciples, some of them is a farmer, some of them is actually tax collector. There's nobody. But after that, when God build them, so it's actually make a huge difference. So this is actually simple philosophy in Feruni that
right.
we want to actually
right.
using up the talent, then
right.
put them in the right place.
Right.
So that actually they can book something that really passionate, that actually automatically they feel happy.
Wow.
And this is actually one of the ways to deliver
right.
happiness.
Right. So one of it was cultivate talent, and obviously that's for the internal team.
Yeah. Mm.
In your customers, what about any pillars that affect your customers in terms of happiness?
Okay. This actually, we have another three. So one is actually talking about the community. Mm-hmm. Actually, 10% of our profit actually we set aside for the community.
CSR?
Yes.
Okay.
Obviously, this is actually from the Bible,
yeah.
teaching that we need to give tithe.
Yeah.
So this is actually 10% that we should go and impact back to the community.
Wow.
So the thing that we do is compare with others is a few things. This one, actually, we have three pillars to build the community. One is actually how we can get the Feruni community to do the community, the CSR
right.
together.
Right.
The second part, that actually, we think that how we can build a sustainable CSR.
Right.
Actually, now we are going to build our talent academy.
Right.
We're going to so-called building the talent academy to so-called take care of those who actually drop off from the school.
Right.
We go and train them to become a professional talent.
Okay.
So this is actually 6-month program.
Right.
Because we believe that we can actually train them to become a professional.
Yes.
We can actually move them from the lower income group to the medium income group.
Wow.
I think this is going to be sustained.
Yes.
Then at the same time, because our store is actually nationwide, after that, after they graduate, we can actually recommend all the business to them.
Right.
So they actually they think that it's going to be a build a sustainable
wow.
CSR.
Wow.
The last part is talking about our internal CSR.
Right.
We always believe that our people must be good, they only can help others.
Right.
So in Feruni,
right.
20% of our profit we actually share among for the, our colleague. So that actually we can
Right, so you're building them up as well.
Yeah, building
up. Wow. So what are the other two pillars?
Another two pillars is actually talking about transformation.
Okay.
How we can transform our people. Then we transform Feruni, then we can transform the entire industry.
Right.
Because all the while, our industry is very boring.
Yeah.
So that we always think how we can actually make it more interesting,
right.
make it like a lifestyle. So
right.
that new generation
right.
will come.
Right.
Of course, the last one is actually we want to run as a value-based organization.
Right.
Everything, the decision that we make, might based on this 10 core value.
Right.
I think this really make us different compared with it in the market.
Right.
That how we run our company.
Right. Wow. Interesting.
Mm.
Interesting. And I remember you mentioned something about Feruni ringgit to me earlier before we started the show. What's that about?
Yeah, actually Feruni is something that our colleague. That is actually because we have always believed that how to build a culture, how to build a good culture. There's always, we believe that you must actually have a set of good value. Then we encourage each and everyone to practice all this great value
values,
that we believe.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then actually we can form the good behavior in the company.
Right.
Then by end of the day, they actually will form a great culture.
Right.
This always believe. So this is actually for real ringgit. It actually is for them to actually can use it to actually redeem a lot of things like food, like drink in the office, like snack in the office. We also, we organize a lot of actually funding in the office. Like we're going to actually have a event in the office. You can actually use our Feruni ringgit to redeem for your massage, for your medicure, a car wash, or such, et cetera, et cetera.
Wow. So really bringing everything alive, and keeping it exciting, and so that people who are maybe non-Christians will feel that in this Christian organization is very different.
Yes, you're right.
So, so tell me a little bit about how different it is in terms of in the eyes of your non-Christian staff or colleagues or even partners. How do they feel about working in a Christian organization and you know, following Christian values to run a business?
Yeah, I think at the end of the day, it's not about a Christian or not about a non-Christian. I think what actually Bible always teaches is something is very great that actually can actually impact each and everyone, including all the whole the community.
Right.
I think at the end, even though my partner is at this moment is not a Christian, but I think they still really believe that we can actually do something great for the community. Right. I think they feel very proud to be associated and together to work with me.
Right.
I think this is a really thank God actually blessing. They actually can
making an impact together.
Yeah, making an impact.
Excellent, excellent.
Hi, this is Doreen Tang from PJEFC, and I'm going to be reading from Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 to 12. There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. What do workers gain from their toil? I have seen the burden God has laid on the human race. He has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in the human heart. Yet no one can fathom what God has done from beginning to end.
We are speaking today to Sisi Ngai from Feruni, Ceramiche. Sisi, tell us a little bit about what was the most difficult decision you had to make.
Okay, I think I can share one of the experience in our business, because in the past it's always a businessman. We try to actually find a way or different way to actually reduce our cost. One of the things we'll be talking about the import things, because our business actually more for a lot of actually importing goods from overseas. So this is always that you need to pay a duty.
Right.
So in the past, what we do is actually we always get a special professional to actually import for
help
us
with the import process.
Yeah, so called professional again. Yeah. But I think this is not something that actually we think that we should do.
Yeah.
But this is also a dilemma in my
it's true.
Me, because if we actually do not go through this professional, that our cost is always will be much higher
than your competitors. Yeah.
Yeah. Precisely. Yeah. This is actually always a struggle for myself. How actually I will overcome it and actually really live in that this so called the Bible teaching that we should be honor and be honest to all these things and transparency and about all these things. So actually it was a struggle for me, but I always believe that when you trust him, then actually he will be find a way for us.
Yes.
So we decided to actually to go. Actually, this is actually also a big changes for us, how we can actually think of, even without all these things, that we still can survive.
Mm.
I think this is actually a big paradigm shift for us as well in terms of the thinking, in terms of how we should run our company.
Mm.
So I think now we already overcome already, even though that we no need to go to the so-called professional.
Right, and you see the growth there and you see the trajectory going up. And it's interesting that you know, if we do it the old way, the easy way out, you know, it somehow also stops the way that we expand our own intelligence and our own innovation and things like that. And I noticed that, you know, with all this going on and the opportunities that God has put you in, your company, I would say, is very innovative. Where are you now in terms of your business? I mean, what are your future plans?
Of course, my future plans, that I want to actually bring our entire concept, how we transform the thing, how we can apply all this biblical value to the other country. So I hope that Feruni, you can actually, in future, can actually bring it to our neighbor country or even to all over the world. It depends how God want me to do it in the marketplace.
As a parting message, what would you advise other Christian business owners?
Trust Him. That's the only thing I can do. And really, I think one thing, the big changes that I changed is in the past, we always, I'm actually always plan. Then only I pray, God, please give me this, give me that. But now I'm actually changed. I ask God, can you actually come in to plan together with me? So can you get involved in my business? What you want me to do in Feruni? What you want me to actually to glorify you? I think this is actually the big changes compared in the past when I pray. I decide everything. God, please give me.
Please bless me.
Please bless me. So now actually God, you get involved. What you want me to do? Wow. I think there's a big changes for myself.
That's great. That's great. Well, thank you for coming on the show and thank you for sharing, you know, your experience and you know, things that God has actually shown you. We have been speaking to CC Ngai from Feruni, Ceramiche.
This is Ray and we're speaking to you from Rhema Radio.
Hello everyone. Do you have a heart to reach the orang asli of Malaysia? Maybe you'd like to minister to them and be a blessing to their lives. Well, if you'd like to, visit us at www.1vm.net. That's One Voice Ministries.
Ku bermimpi lagi seperti tempo hari, apa artinya? Ku rasa seperti terjatuh, tapi kemana belum diketahui. Di hati rasa ketenangan, tapi keraguan ini. Kini ku mencari, ku cuba mengerti, ku keliru, tapi ku rasa seperti terjatuh, tapi kemana belum diketahui. Di hati rasa ketenangan, tapi keraguan ini. Dengan persoalan, mampukah ku berdiri? Bertaruhkan segalanya, mampukah ku berdiri? Mampukah ku berdiri?
This is Paul Gan. I'm a filmmaker. I'm currently worshipping in SAVKL. God is really great. I learned through a lot of incidences in my life. One of it was back then when I was directing and producing my film, The Boy Rocked the World. I did not have any money. So I remember in the Bible, in Psalms 37 verse 25, it says that now I've been young. I was young. Back then I was young and now I'm old. I never seen a child of God begging for bread. So that was actually a good reminder for me back then, and I hold on to it very tightly. And God really did provide me the money for the film. And as well, the most adventurous thing I did with my then girlfriend was that I was praying for money for our wedding. Alright, so 2 months before our wedding, we literally had this, like, you know, 5,000 ringgit in our accounts. We didn't have much. But 1 month before it, we managed to win a competition that gives us 30,000 ringgit worth of prizes. Sorry, we actually managed to win 30,000 ringgit for the prize. So, with that, it was really, really amazing. God really does provide for us. Now for me, it's a continued journey to remind myself to always trust in the Lord for His providence.
This is Dr. Peggy Wong from Living Hope, and I worship in SIBKL. I know the festive season is around the corner, and Chinese New Year is a fantastic time for us to be bonding, to be sharing the gospel with our family and relatives, and we can share about testimonies and the goodness of God. Spend time with your family, because this is a very important time where we see maybe 2 or even 3 or even 4 generations together. Let us be the salt and light to our family members, and we just share our testimony. It is hard to tell them about God in this picture, but our testimony will show and reflect the goodness of God. So just don't go using your handphone and WhatsApp and WeChat and all that. Just put everything aside, spend time with your family and talk and laugh, so that they will see that you are different from the rest of the family members. So have fun and enjoy your Chinese New Year and collect lots of ang pao.
This segment features music by Unabashed. Don't miss out on the sermon People with the Fire of God by Elder Dorai Manikam of FGAKL in the next segment.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I found it on Rhema Radio.